U.S. President Donald Trump stopped short of killing the nuclear deal with Iran, but could his action to decertify it impact North Korea's nuclear program? Let's take a look at what the experts are saying in this report.
The Iran deal was one of the worst and most one-sided transactions the United States has ever entered into.
نمیدونه که برجام نه ماده‌ای بهش اضافه میشه، نه تبصره‌ای بهش اضافه میشه، نه بندی بهش اضافه میشه.
Trump hated the Iran deal and on Saturday took the major step to decertify it. He didn't kill it, although he could have, and even threatened so if Congress did not go along with him on Iran. Also, as a multilateral deal to which China, France, Russia and the UK along with Germany are also party, the United States withdrawal alone would have severely damaged but not killed the deal. Experts fear that Trump's move could trigger global instability.
This will have a ripple effect on North Korea. I can't imagine that Kim Jong-un, the leader of North Korea, will now want to voluntarily give up his nuclear weapons when he sees that the United States has so easily changed its mind on the Iran nuclear deal.
It's a very major mistake. There is no evidence that on the nuclear program, Iran has cheated in the agreement that the UK and other powers, along with the United States, entered into with Iran. So basically, for political reasons or for personal reasons, it's unclear which, he is basically throwing open the door to Iran's nuclear program one more time. I think that is very dangerous.
This is not the first time Donald Trump has reversed major U.S. policy decisions. Trump pulled out of Paris climate deal in June 2017. Trump threatened to pull out of NAFTA, saying it favored Mexico and Canada. In June this year, Trump stunned the world by announcing that America will withdraw from the Paris Climate Accord, accusing India and China of benefiting the most from it. Not just that, Trump has been warning that the US will also pull out from the North American Free Trade Agreement, calling it unfair, while also accusing Mexico of stealing American jobs. The U.S. Congress has a 60-day window to decide whether to restore agreements previous sanctioned, modify them, or do nothing. It's not clear if the Republicans, despite their majority in Congress, can get members to rally behind Trump. Some are opposed to the agreement. Others say Trump is setting the U.S. on the path to World War III. Bureau Report, WION.